Okay, so I'm gonna make a Harley mallet because I have a costume. That's a Harley mallet dress, and I want some accessories and props to use when I take pictures of myself because it's gonna be a little bit more intense than other than my other stuff I have. And so I've already gone and done the first step, which is I cut out circles. See, I have two of them. Cut them out already. And I used a Staples box top. As you can see, probably shouldn't have shown that. But, yeah, you can see it's pretty thick cardboard, which you wouldn't kind of use on this part because you don't want it too flimsy. You want to have something sturdy to keep it down. Alright, and after I did that, I cut them out. And oh, I just used a circular container to trace it. You can use a compass if you want, and you can make it smaller than what I have here. After that, I have two lines, as you can see, kind of. Right here, I don't see it too well. But yeah, I have two lines. That's how long my mallet will be. And all I did was take a ruler and measure out how wide it was from here to the holding of the cardboard box, which is pretty thin because I want it to be this one to be bendable. So it's gonna make a circle and go on the outside of the other box, other cells. And all I did was measure it down all the way to keep it an even length. And I haven't cut that out, but I'm gonna stop it and do that right now. As you can see, that really didn't take too much time to do. So basically what I'm going to be doing, don't mind that, but this is rolling it up so it covers and makes a nice outside for it. As you can see, it's kind of starting to come together like that. Okay, so for the next part, I'm going to use my glue gun, and you don't really have to use a glue gun, you can use masking tape, but I don't have any of that right now on hand, so I'm just going to do it. It's going to keep it a little bit more secure than masking tape will in the end process, so you might want to do it, and it's going to be kind of difficult because I have no real outlets in my room. I only have like two right here and then two like way down there. And then on the other side of my room. And they're all kind of filled on this side right here with my light and my camera power box, so I'm kind of stuck. So I have very little extension, and I'm right-handed. It's gonna be kind of fun. And I just got hot glue on my hand. Way to go, me. And I just got hot glue on my hand. Here. Okay, so I'm gonna put it down and kind of work. Don't make fun of me. Or else weird eyed work here. stopped the video because it was getting kind of hard to make sure I had the angle right and get this thing glued at the same time. So, I have most of it done at this point. And you can tell by my edges it's not 100% lined to the core, but that's okay because it's going to be covered with the decoupage and paper mache in a bit. And you can see I left a little bit of a hole. This is because I want to fill it up with paper so I can hopefully try to get these bumps out. You can't really see there's a big tent in there. So I'm just going to try and fix that. Basically done now. See, it's kind of shape. Feel it? Pretty big. Bigger than I thought it was gonna be, but I like it. I like it. I like it. I like it. You can see I still have a dent here, but I think I might put my handle in this part. Looks like a good spot to me. And like I said about the edges, I can't really get a good angle of it, but you can see it's kind of odd, not even, but I think I'm going to go over it with hot glue again, just from the inside of it out, from the outside again, to keep it secure. I might not, I really don't know at this point. I want to see how it holds up. And with the paper, it gives it a little bit of weight to it. Could have put a little more, but I think this will do. So, that's it for this part.